Welcome back once again, Real People, Real Life, Wichita, Kansas, America. And we're going to have you doing that here in just a minute. Okay, we're here now with Chef Akamut, right? Yes. And this is kind of like a soft opening that we're at right now for your Noble House.
Noble House Hawaiian Foods.
Mm-hmm. Wow. And this is at 3238 East Douglas Avenue in Wichita, Kansas, which is basically just east of Hillside.
Yes.
Okay, and it's going to be on the north side of the road. So as you're coming up, you're going to see it. I can't remember the name of these apartments. They're absolutely beautiful.
Hillcrest.
Hillcrest, right across from Hillcrest.
And the Crown Uptown.
And Crown Uptown, exactly. And what you're going to be open Wednesday through?
Saturday.
Okay.
11 a.m. to 8 p.m.
Okay.
Until March.
Until March.
And then we'll work on a grand opening.
Right, the big grand. I've heard a couple ideas, and I'm not going to say anything, but I'm excited. You have to be excited too, right?
Yes.
Yeah? Okay. Now, you also have a food truck here, right?
Yes, we have Noble House Hawaiian Plate Lunch.
Yeah.
It's been here in Wichita for 1 year, but it's been in existence for 3 years.
Right. And you have a history. I mean, your life has been in restaurant business.
Yes.
And so has your parents, apparently.
Yes.
That's pretty cool. So the theme here, and you can tell because I love the artwork here, it's kind of a Hawaiian theme.
Yeah, it's a Hawaiian plate lunch restaurant.
Exactly. With a Hawaiian theme. The artwork is beautiful. I'm sorry, but it's absolutely beautiful.
You can thank the boss lady.
Okay, yeah, the boss lady here, by the way, didn't want to come on camera because she's really, really busy, but she's fantastic. Okay, so you have, oh my gosh, what do you have?
This one is Huli Huli chicken, which is marinated and charbroiled chicken.
Okay.
Okay, it comes with 2 scoops of rice, a scoop of macaroni salad, and a 1/2 pound of meat. And this one
is
2 scoops of rice, scoop macaroni salad, and 1/2 pound of meat. And this is Kalua pork and cabbage. It's just, you can't have a Hawaiian plate lunch restaurant without Kalua pork.
Right.
And, that's the basic definition.
Mm-hmm. And this is what, would be the regular if you're ordering.
Yeah, this is the regular. Yeah. It's a 2 pound plate, not to scare you.
It's a lot.
That's a lot of food.
Wow. Wow.
Well, we want to make sure that you get ample portions for a decent price.
Okay.
I can tell already you will not leave hungry.
No. Okay, you're going to start with that. I'll try this. Okay. Now, do you make your own salad here?
We make our own everything.
Oh, my God. I love pasta salad.
Yep. And this is soy sauce.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Good. For your soft opening, people are already coming in. You got to love that.
Oh, my goodness.
Is it good? What do you... It's just...
My mouth is still watering.
What are some of the other things that you, some of the other dishes, some of the other favorites, and some of the plans? Because you're going to keep growing.
Right. So what we're going to do is, right now, today, the first day, it's Friday the 13th, my lucky day.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. It sure is.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
We're going to... We have 4 items today. We have Kalua pork and cabbage, mm-hmm. We have teriyaki steak, aloha garlic shrimp, and Huli Huli chicken. Next week, we'll probably add 1 or 2 more, and by March 1st, we'll have the entire menu where we're going to have 8 to 12 items. We have aloha, the lobster hand rolls.
Those are amazing. I've had those.
We have all the combos. So you can get pig and chicken, you can get pig and beef, you can get pig, chicken and chicken, you can get chicken and beef, shrimp and chicken, beef or pig. And, those are the mixed plates. And then we have, a soda fountain. We have the cakey menu, which is the kids menu. And basically a small, they're very small. And the chicken, it's $1.99 and $2.90.
But the prices are amazing. Prices, but the quality. Oh my God! This is just absolutely fantastic. Okay, what made you decide to do this?
I've had a few sushi bars.
Okay.
More than a few. I had a few Hawaiian plate lunch places, mm-hmm. and I had a steakhouse. And when I came to Wichita and Kansas, period, I was like, they don't have this, they don't have that.
You're right, we don't.
Like, we serve hand rolls, which are sushi hand rolls, but 90% of the sushi bars in this town don't serve that.
You're right. Okay.
And so, yes. John's got it, don't worry.
I gotta say, I would not have ordered anything with cabbage because I...
You don't like it?
Oh my God.
Well, she does now.
Well, good. That's besides, and then we have what we call ahi poke, yeah, which is our number one seller out of everything. What's and that's yellowfin tuna, sweet onions, green onions, sesame seeds, sesame oil, seven Japanese spices, a little bit of soy sauce, over 4 ounces of rice.
Count me in on that one.
And today, we are introducing the albacore poke. Albacore from Fiji. And I actually, I'm going to go in the back and finish making it, and then I'm going to bring it out.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my God.
So, you know, let me know when you're ready, and I'll jump back there and finish it.
I could just eat the cabbage.
I know, right? Oh my God, this is to die for. We've got a couple of our camera crew here. We're going to have them come in and kind of join us, and we're going to share for a minute.
Yeah, let me grab some forks for you guys. Okay. And then
this is fantastic. Wichita, you're going to love this place. Okay, that's all I can tell you. Just leave it running, and let's get a feel for the place. Get a feel for all of us eating and loving every minute of this. If we keep it rolling, we're just going to keep it rolling. Be jealous, because it's fantastic.
Oh, my mouth is still watering.
I know. I got to try your
fork. I can't tell you enough how good this is.
Try that for a bite. Try that. Melts
the
in your mouth. I know.
Automatically.
Okay, I would have never thought of doing cabbage ever. Oh my god. Oh my god. I would have never thought of that, but that is really good.
It's phenomenal.
Holy moly. Come on, kids. Come on. We're going to be over here enjoying. I promise you, you're going to want to be here. The big grand opening is going to be coming soon. This is just kind of their soft opening, but it is going to be Wednesday through Saturday. I know, I can't either. So if we just sit here and eat for a minute, don't mind us, because it's fantastic. Oh, cameraman, diving in.
Oh, let me show you how you're supposed to eat.
Don't be taking all of it now.
Why not?
Oh. No.
Okay, this looks awesome.
They make their own macaroni salad, too.
Yes. And the sticky rice.
Oh my God.
Okay, Ra, you gotta come and have a bite of this.
Come on, girl. It's okay. We love ya.
Are you talking to us?
Yes, we love you, girls.
Okay.
And thank you for being awesome today.
Oh, I'll let you feed yourself. I was gonna feed you, but.
Yeah,
right?
Let's not feed me, okay?
Your mouth will not stop watering.
Oh my God.
I told you.
Is it good?
What's this?
That's just macaroni salad.
Soy sauce?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Now this and then the sticky rice. Pork.
That's marinated.
Chicken.
No,
I think it's the I'm butchering it if I try to say it.
Halloui chicken.
Begin there, young lady.
Oh, I am.
Man, this is good. So we really don't have a Hawaiian themed restaurant in Wichita anymore. So this is kind of a first. We did maybe back in the 70s, but nothing like this. I mean, this is traditional, phenomenal Hawaiian food. Oh my God.
This is really good. Like, I'm not playing.
I really don't even want to stop eating.
I know. So
if you think I'm ignoring you, I am.
We are. Sorry. We're enjoying every minute of this.
I know. Can I just have this whole thing?
Just keep diving in, baby. It's okay.
Must run in the family grabbing a plate. Huh?
Yeah, it does. We see that. Oh my God. Did you try the sticky rice?
Yes. Yeah, and I think he touched on it, but there's some exciting new additions that will be coming into the restaurant that aren't here just yet. I'm not going to give them away, but it's going to be
good
one
stuff.
Of the spots to be.
Yeah, you're going to want to be here.
You know, I got to come back.
You
really?
Yes. Okay. I'm
yeah.
They're also partnering with a couple of other local businesses.
Oh,
I don't want to give that away yet either, because I'm not sure if I'm allowed to, but it's going to be fun.
Baby. Hey, try that one now.
Where is it?
Oh my God.
Okay.
My saliva glands can still.
Dive in, guys.
Let me get another fork.
If you mix the meat with the macaroni, oh my gosh, it like complements each other, the taste. It is so amazing. Oh my gosh. Oh, I'm in love.
Get on there.
We can use our pickers.
Can we just hire one of them to cook for us all the time?
Like, wouldn't that be cool?
They do catering, just so everybody else
Doesn't
knows.
It?
They, as far as I know, they're still going to be available for catering as well.
Oh, man.
we're going to continue the food truck back.
Yeah,
right.
You were so right. Holy crap, that's good. You got to try the macaroni.
Doesn't it and just complement each other?
It's so good. Mm-hmm. Oh, it's so good.
Oh, my God, I'm so happy right now.
Like, I know.
We all have a happy tummy. What can we say?
Nothing matters but this food right here.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Hey, hey, hey.
I love rice. Oh,
my favorite. Oh, yes. She was so right, right?
Me too. Oh, my goodness. Yes, that's perfect.
Wow. Okay, I think the chef is making like a tuna dish, which I can't wait because I'm a tuna freak. But we,
I don't know that I've ever had real fresh tuna.
Real tuna is to die for.
I think he said it was from Fiji.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So if you're bringing in anything, your seafoods and a lot of that kind of stuff from Fiji, you're doing very well because it's good quality. And some of the tuna steaks, you know, which I have not had a tuna steak since I was in Maui, by the way, you know, but they are phenomenal. So good.
I'm excited to see all the people that are coming in.
I know.
Even though
this is their soft
they're
opening,
not officially
and it's gonna be
open.
How awesome.
Yes.
This is so cool. We're just sitting here eating.
I'm excited to be a part of it.
I know.
Thanks
I know.
For having us.
Yes, thank you guys.
Oh my God. Thank you but, for watching us eat.
I'm on camera.
Not me, I'm
just eating from the side.
No, we're gonna get you.
We're gonna mix all this together.
Oh my God.
Oh my gosh, this is so good.
Wow.
Sorry for hogging.
I haven't tried it.
What is up
rice.
With the seasoning?
I would not.
It is?
Yeah. I would not have ordered. I was telling him anything with
can we
cabbage.
Just move
and
to Hawaii.
Oh my gosh.
Right.
It's warm there. That's great.
No ice storms in Hawaii.
I'll sit in the ocean in Memphis.
Right.
I forgot today was Friday the 13th. We're having a great day so far.
I know. I'm okay yes. with all that. It's all fine with me.
Are you done?
No, I got to go take a picture of some food he's bringing out.
Oh. I love to eat.
Hey, Keith. Oh,
yeah,
Keith, Browning, ask if we could have a glass of water. Mm. Ask him if you could get us a glass of water.
I'm sorry, guys, but I'm just hogging.
Go for
it,
honey.
I can't
honey.
Stop.
Go. Let's feed all of us, man.
Yeah, that is set in front of me. I ate the whole thing.
Right? Mm. Unbelievable.
I was afraid because the name of it, but it is so worth it. Oh,
exactly.
My gosh.
Who knew?
Yeah. I'm so glad he specifically brought that one out because when I come here, I would never. Oh.
Are you ready?
Yes. What do we have next? What do we have?
Is debuting in Wichita today.
Oh,
this
gosh,
is
that's beautiful.
Albacore from Fiji, and this is.
Oh, it smells divine.
They're albacore pokey from Fiji.
This is
something that we. I've been wanting to do here.
God, you smell that.
I just need to make sure that Wichita is ready.
Okay.
Since our ahi tuna is number one, our number one seller.
I'm going to put this in a couple.
So basically, it's 6 ounces of fish and sweet onions and sauce and over 4 ounces of rice.
Wowza. Okay, this, you know, I was just saying that if you're bringing in tuna from... Fiji, oh my God, people are going to love it. Unbelievable.
I mean, we get yellowfin tuna from Spain.
Wow.
So you're bringing in the really good of the good.
Yeah.
The best of the best. Wow.
Wow.
Oh, we're trying. You might want to jump in there.
Oh, yeah.
I know, that's
waiting.
Why I was, oh, I was waiting.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah. It's not, it is not your canned tuna, I can tell you that.
No. Oh, oh man.
And most of the time,
I mean, a little bit
delicate.
Of everything.
Yes, you do.
When you
get a piece of tuna.
I got a little piece of tuna.
When you eat albacore tuna, 99% of the time it's seared.
You're right, it is.
That
right.
is not seared on
oh,
purpose. I want it to melt in your mouth.
It is.
Oh, man.
Oh, my God.
That is delicious. I was afraid,
and the
but
seasonings?
I'm not.
Oh, yeah, the seasonings.
Well, when I have the sushi bars, I would
is
basically...
Is that sushi? Is that
technically, good? Because it's...
No, it's...
No?
That's a Hawaiian dish. Hawaiian plate lunch has been around for almost 200 years,
mm-hmm.
and poke has been around for about 200 years,
oh
so...
Oh, gosh.
You know.
Oh, my God. Okay, so you've got the onions.
It's sweet onions,
mm-hmm.
Carrots.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't had to repeat this 1,000 times because this is the first time, so...
Right.
I guess I'm going to have to create the...
You're going to have to because...
Yeah, the dressing, it just... Your
yeah, what
flavors
is that?
Are so good.
What's that?
It's kind of like a dressing of some sort. It's just phenomenal.
Well, it has sesame oil, seaweeds, sesame oils, sesame seeds, green onions.
Mm.
I want to say, and the difference between the onions and the regular ahi poke
mm-hmm.
is we take the sweet onions and we rinse them and we take the pungent and outness out of it. Mm-hmm. Even though you don't have to, because these sweet onions have more sugar than an orange.
Oh, wow.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh.
So, yeah.
That's where that sweetness is coming from, because I thought maybe it was in some sort of a dressing.
No,
but
no,
that's
no,
what
no.
it is. Unbelievable.
And the fish is just, it's not seared, so there's no way for it to be tough.
Right.
I love the texture. I like the crunchiness of the vegetables and the nice tenderness of the tuna in it.
And very soon we will offer a vegetarian poke, and instead of the tuna or the albacore, it will have portobello mushrooms.
Oh, oh wow.
So
perfect.
To simulate
the meat.
Yeah. I was afraid you were going to say tofu, which I don't have anything against tofu, but...
but I'll take the portobello mushrooms any day
exactly.
over tofu.
I mean, you know, if you wanted to simulate meat, tofu, unless I tempura it, but then if you have tempura and you roll it around with sauce, it's just soggy.
Right.
So,
okay.
No,
if tofu's made right, it's good, but you have to have it made right.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, I mean...
this is...
We are going to offer, like, people who don't want the rice and the macaroni salad, we're going to offer... very soon, or you know, as you know, that's why we have a soft opening, so we can add to it. It's gonna have a big green salad. You'll be able to put hooli hooli chicken on top, you'll be able to put steak on top. And traditionally in Hawaii, we would take ramen noodles and not cooked and sprinkle on. I'm probably gonna take that out because that's not paleo. And you know, people who just want to go protein and vegetables, meat and vegetables,
right?
They need that, and there has to be an option,
right? Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
That's great.
So,
when did you come to Kansas? I'm just curious.
I came to help out a friend's restaurant in 2011, right here in Wichita, and then I had some friends in Topeka, so I went and visited. And then after I consulted here in Wichita, I went to Topeka and got back and forth. I'm pretty heavy into CrossFit, and a friend had a CrossFit gym that I thought he might need help with. That didn't work out. That's how I met Boss Lady. She was a CrossFit instructor at his place, and the rest is kind of his.
The rest is kind of all filled together, and here you are.
Yep. So
this is amazing.
We are.
Wow.
Do you still plan on attending food truck rallies and
the truck is its own entity.
Okay, good.
I mean, this is Noble House Hawaiian Foods. That's Noble House Hawaiian Plate Lunch.
Okay.
It's probably going to do even more. We did an amazing amount of weddings last year without a brick and mortar.
I was saying that when you were off camera, I was talking about the catering and all still that.
Available for catering. Yeah, we are going to do a lot of caterings. We are going to do a lot of, because we have a brick and mortar, traditionally, they'll probably, I've already had somebody inquire about 40 people, what they need, so on and so forth. And, you know, they can just come pick up their trays, put it in their, their business, their boardroom, their house, whatever.
Very good.
Just pick it up too.
We don't have to deliver it. They can pick it up. We can deliver it. It just depends. We're in the customer service business, and it seems to be a fleeting thing, here in America.
Sadly. But you're doing a fantastic job of not letting that go away.
I'm gonna try.
I know. Oh my God. What is your favorite thing on your menu?
It would probably be the poke or the kalua pig.
Mm-hmm.
We have some stuff that will never be on the menu.
Good enough things about it.
I don't want to say, but you just got to come down and try it out.
Exactly.
Right.
But, like, say you were to get a lobster hand roll or a poke and maybe combine them or something. People who know, and as we teach you to be a good customer, you'll know too.
You'll know exactly what you want. Unbelievable. Are you going to have any desserts, Hawaiian-themed desserts or anything like that?
We're working on it.
Really?
Good. We're working on the desserts. We're going to have mochi ice cream probably by Wednesday.
Okay, cool.
And we usually, from the truck, we would sell out.
Oh, sure.
But then if I ordered cases of this, this, and this, it would be gone. And mochi ice cream is basically ice cream, green tea, mango, strawberry, red bean, and then you wrap it in mochi, which is pounded out rice.
Yep.
And then you roll it around in powdered sugar, and then you freeze them.
Wow.
And that's what a mochi is.
It's good. Very, very good. Yeah.
I've never thought about
it. Now, you said those on the truck, though.
Yeah, and the truck basically is going to benefit because whatever we served here, that means we'll have an abundance of. And then, you know, when somebody wants, you know, this or that. I mean, sometimes people call up or Facebook me or whatever, hey, are you going to have this today? And sometimes I wasn't planning on it, but
because you have this.
And because we're so customer service oriented, right. We try to, I say, you know, put shrimp on the menu too.
Right, wow. When
I wouldn't. I mean, because, you know, one person asks and then one person asks and, you know,
you have to do
it has to, you know, it's all supply and demand.
It's definitely done before. Oh my gosh.
Well, and that's debuted right now. You guys are the first people to ever have.
Wow, I feel privileged.
Me too.
In Wichita.
Oh my God, I do feel very privileged right now.
In Kansas.
In Kansas, okay. Oh,
it's good.
Oh my God.
As time goes by, we'll have octopus pokey.
Yeah. So good. What are you going to keep eating?
I need to take this.
It's okay. We're just going to be informal today.
Eat. Yeah.
It's
gone.
Taste that tuna.
I know. I've been eating it. I don't even like it raw. Is this raw?
Basically.
I've never had it like this before. And it's good. I've never ate it.
I know. I thought it was going to be grossed out. But
I know. For people.
It is so good.
Who are scared of eating like this for the first time, don't be. It's so good.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, exactly.
This is going to definitely be just something like maybe that you're not used to having, especially here in Wichita. And you may look at some of the names on the menu and be like, oh, my God, what is that? And he's right. I mean, these are traditional Hawaiian dishes. Unbelievable. You know, my favorite place when I go to Hawaii is going to be Maui. And a lot of what I'm having here is exactly what I would be enjoying there. Of course, I would have a beachfront property and some beach and, you know, palm trees and, you know, a couple things like that.
Take me there.
Right? But I understand he's going to be getting cocktails and, you know, and I think that those, you know, Hawaiian cocktails, believe me, are going to be fantastic. I promise. Oh, my God, this is good. Oh, my gosh. Keep going, guys.
Getting the hours on the door over here.
Yes.
Okay, I'm full. I can't do anymore.
Oh, I can eat all of this.
All of it? Girl, you're crazy.
This stuff must have something in it to where you can just pack it in because I'm not stopping.
Oh.
It is so delicious. Even if your stomach is so full, you just want to keep packing it in your mouth.
Oh.
Oh my God, yes.
You're enjoying that?
Yes.
A little more maybe than we should.
Oh my God.
That's okay.
Oh my God.
That's quite all right.
But on that, I'm on.
I was just saying on camera when you had to break for a minute, but you know, a lot of times here in Wichita, people will see things on a menu and they haven't heard of them before, or you know, it's not that same old meat and potato. Yeah,
right.
So I want them to know that this is true. I mean, yeah, it's going to be exotic because it's not your same old that you would find here all the time. But you know, when I am in Maui or when I go to Hawaii, this is so traditional what I would see there.
Yeah, this is not resort food.
Mm-mm.
There is not pineapples.
Right.
This is what you would eat,
exactly.
Or what I would eat at my house,
mm-hmm.
in Hawaii,
mm-hmm.
and every other local person.
Yeah,
this is what we eat.
And that's what true. The environment is like here, like a home.
Yeah.
Like inviting us into your home. So
the reason
really
why
awesome.
The tables are like this is so we can push them all together. And like when we have luau's and stuff, there will be probably 8 10-foot tables.
Yeah.
8 10-foot tables in the parking lot.
Oh.
And because this holds, what, 30, 40 people?
Yeah.
And we need more.
Yeah.
So you're going to do traditional luau's?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
It may not be every month like I wanted because the dancers are so far away. They're in Independence, Missouri. And there's a big Polynesian community there. And there's a few here. Yeah. But not any booth. There's three little troops there. There's dancers. There's fire knife. There's a lot.
Yeah.
And we last year we did their park gathering. They told me there might be 500 people. There was 5,000 people.
Wow. Wow.
I'm not surprised though.
Yeah, and we literally were doing 500 an hour. 500 people. An hour.
Wow.
That's just out of the food truck.
Not very many of the food trucks can get your food out as fast.
That was insane.
We try.
You did an amazing 500 people an hour. That's phenomenal.
Yeah.
My gosh. And I know we're going to come back and get some more here in a little bit, but wow. Okay, one more time. Noble House, located at, what's the address?
3238 East Douglas Avenue.
And you're on Facebook?
We are on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Mm-hmm. We have a website. It's www.noblehousehawaiian.com. And soft opening until March. And then we'll start advertising and whatnot.
And get ready. Wichita, you're going to love this. I promise. Once again, it's Real People, Real Life, Wichita, Kansas, America! This is phenomenal. This is phenomenal. This is phenomenal.